I guess this is what I've dreamed of my whole life. There was no other comedy show in all of television that equaled the Max Prince show. Not in 1953, there wasn't. An hour and a half of you every Saturday night, completely live. Now, I was actually a writer on it. My name is Lucas Brickman. Max was unlike any comedian I'd seen before. He didn't tell jokes. He didn't say funny lines. He was just funny. But on camera, when he had to be himself, like introducing a guest, he couldn't say four intelligent consecutive words without mumbling or popping. And I like Max a lot. Mostly because he treats his writers with respect. And he pays them more than anyone else. If I seem nervous to you, it's because it's only my second week here. One of the other writers left, and now I'm here on a 4-week trial contract. So if I'm going to prove myself, I'm going to have to do it fast. My problem is, I'm shy. But I did manage to get one really funny line on last week's show. Unfortunately, Max coughed on that line, and no one in America heard him. I'm going to prove myself. My entire future depends on my finding a voice for my career. Or a cure for Max's cough.
I did it. Broke every record on the Henry Hudson Parkway, door to door, Scarsdale, 57th Street, 28 minutes, 12 seconds, made every light. Now, can you imagine if I had a car? But a bump. How you doing, Arnie?
Fine. It's Lucas.
It's not Arnie. I called you Arnie all last week. You never said a word.
I didn't know you were talking to me.
You're gonna have to learn to speak up, kid. Otherwise, these killers will eat you alive. Hang this up, will ya? Be careful with it. It's an antique.
It feels nice. Where'd you get it?
Took it off a dead bullfighter in Spain. Well, what do I know? It's got style, class. I got a flair for dressing, no?
A flair? You've got a rocket. Where'd you get the beret?
The beret is legitimate. Got it in Paris, the last one sold.
The last beret in Paris?
MGM bought them all up for the Gene Kelly movies. What do I know about berets? Plus, I look like a putz in this, so why would I wear it?
Why?
Because people notice it. Look at me without a beret. Invisible, right? But watch. Just watch. Now I'm someone. Maybe I know Ernest Hemingway. I go to the French movies and laugh at all the jokes.
Ha ha ha.
I mean, right?
Well?
What am I? Good looking? No. Am I smart? Nah. But am I funny? Yes. And compared to the comic minds in this very room, I'm Herbert Hoover's kitchen help. So, I wear yellow suede shoes on Christmas, and when I walk in here, Max Prince laughs. If Max Prince laughs, my kids eat this week.
Max didn't talk to me once last week.
All right, rent you the beret. $50 a week. If he picks up your option, $75.
No, that's okay.
It's a gift. I'm up to my butt in berets.
You don't think you're funny?
Cheap. Cheap laughs. These guys are Tiffany's. I'm a wholesaler. Bulk, volume, that's my humor. Where's the onion rolls? It's in my contract. My agent negotiated for onion rolls.
Isn't that one?
This is a Jewish hockey puck. Smell it. Does it smell like an onion roll?
I can't smell. I have a cold. But I could listen to it if you want.
You're funny, Arnie. You're too quiet, but you're funny. Don't be too funny. I have a wife and two kids to support. It's murder on my mistress. Yeah, you'll be alright.
Did Max get in yet?
Excuse me. Am I interrupting?
Forgive me, pay no attention.
The woman apologizes 3 times in 1 sentence and still hasn't said good morning yet.
I'm sorry, absolutely unforgivable. I have a lot on my mind. It's an affliction, common to geniuses. He's kidding.
You like your coat, Luke? Val buys all her clothes at Ellis Island.
All right, be funny before work starts. So, what have we got here? Nothing but onion rolls? Emmy, do me a favor. Look for Pumpernickel Biggle.
Her name is Arnie.
It's Lucas.
Arnie? It's not even Arnie. It's not even Pumpernickel.
Milt, this is not dating me angry. I didn't have breakfast. I didn't have sleep. Max calls my house at 12 a.m. midnight. He never calls my house at 12 a.m. midnight. Unless there's trouble.
12 a.m. is midnight, putz.
Milt! Don't bother me.
I can't believe there's not one pumpernickel bagel. There's one.
Ah! Thank you, Lucella. You'll go find the show. Look at this. Oh! Already sliced! This is why my father brought us to America!
Sliced bagels?
Mine came for chocolate pudding. In Poland, they can make it, but they can never get it in the little cups.
I wonder if Max called anybody else last night? Did he call you? Lucella?
Lucas. No, why would he call me? Is there anything wrong?
I don't know yet. I was up last night. Listen, I saw, without a doubt, the most brilliant play I have ever seen in my life. I'll remember it as long as I live.
What was it?
Ibsen. Hedda Gobler.
And a gobbler. Is this about a turkey?
You illiterate. I'll bet you $500 you don't even know Hendrik Ibsen's first name.
You just said Henrik.
Thank you.
All right, I'll bet you $250.
Not funny. All right, my mistakes are funnier than what he makes up.
Is that the tune? Where is everyone?
You don't have any idea where Max called?
None. He talked to my maid last night in Swedish. Double talk Swedish. Two of them who's only been here 3 weeks from Peru. She was still crying when we came home. Something's up, I swear to God.
Honey, can I have an outside line, please?
Who is it?
I don't know. Let's see who answers.
It seems incredible, like growing up in Russia, that you become a comedy writer. I mean, do they even have television there?
Television? They don't even have doorbells yet. And yet, the greatest comedy in the world came from Russia. But in Russia today, comedy is dead. Lenin killed it, Stalin buried it. And what have they got now? The most corrupt and insidiously evil political regime since Ivan, the son of a gun. No, sir. Until there are humane reforms in that country, I lost my tongue of the language. But Chewie! I'm so sorry. I got cream cheese on you.
Hello? Who's this? No, I'm calling Colette.
Colette? We've got the show to write and you're calling some girl named Colette?
Colette. Her name is Colette, not Collect. Why don't you go to Berlitz and drive them crazy?
Milt, this is not good to be angry.
All right, then put me down for Wednesday. Yes, I'm holding.
Hmm. back time to come late.
Sorry, I stopped to get some cigarettes.
Brian Doyle, good guy, good writer, lousy smoker. Hey guys, please, I'm cheating on the phone here and I can't hear a thing. That's it, adult $50 fine. I gotta go, honey, they just raised the rates. Oh, Brian's smiling, something happened. He met someone at the convent.
5 days, count them guys, because that's all you get. Because on Friday, this good-looking Irishman's leaving the show. The Gentile makes good.
Where are you going?
I think they call it Hollywood? I saw the screenplay to Metro. MGM, you must have heard of it.
MGM? That's great!
Abner VP's leaving show on Friday. Abner VP's leaving to fly to Hollywood. Abner VP's sold the screenplay to MGM or 20th Century Fox or something. That's it. I want this guest started immediately before Max gets here. See what's on the news. Milt, see what ideas we got on the board. See what's a hit picture. Maybe there's a Marlon Brando movie Max can do.
Marlon Brando.
What did I say?
Marlon Brando.
My way was funny. Hey, Brian? Maybe whenever you're through destroying that contact, you'll find time to come up with an idea.
Come here, Luke. These guys still don't believe me. That's history, kid. Right up there with David Selznick buying Gone with the Wind. Go on, read.
Your agent called and said, MGM will get back to you.
go on. Gonna listen to you?
That's it.
That's it? MGM will get back to you is a deal?
I got a call from the coast last night. They'll sign the contract as soon as they okay the script.
They didn't okay it yet?
They'll okay it as soon as they read it.
They didn't read it yet?
They'll read it as soon as I write it. Here. Up here. Every page, every word, every comma.
They made a deal through a finger pointing to your head?
You're jealous, Cubis. I told the idea to my agent told it to MGM, and now the whole studio's crazy about it. Look at these guys, Luke. In 30 years, they'll be running game shows, and I'll be VP of MGM.
I categorically present your remarks. This is, without a doubt, the most brilliant writing staff in the history of television. And I would rather stay here until my prostate falls out and sell out to the drink and garbage of Hollywood. Gold's truth, even if they ask me.
What if they ask you?
I'm up to anything. You can tell them.
Did you see this? This week's Time Magazine. Pope Pius approved of psychoanalysis. This means from now on, confessions will be $80 an hour.
Kenny Franks, born genius. They say she was writing jokes for Jack Benny when she was 14. I wasn't even allowed to stay up for Jack Benny when I was 14.
You think maybe this Pope thing will make a sketch for us?
I think we'd all have to take communion first.
So, Mrs. Vitamin, what kind of pill are we taking today?
Nicotine tablets. Now I can get cancer without having to smoke. How you doing, Luke?
I don't know. Nobody tells me.
Don't worry. Max thinks you're going to be great.
Did he say so?
Nope. But I'll tell him he did. He doesn't remember.
Did you hear about Max calling Val at 12 a.m. midnight?
Did you know he called me at 11:30?
Max did?
He was sitting in his den, hammered drunk, with a loaded shotgun in his lap.
Son of a gun. He told you this?
Well, it sort of dribbled out of his mouth, but I got most of it.
Son of a gun. He had a loaded gun?
He said he got another threatening letter in his mailbox last night.
There wasn't me. I sent my letter last week.
Son of a gun. Did he call the police?
Well, he said he was taking the matter into his own hands, so it's him against them now.
Son of a gun. Sorry, Val. That one was open.
What do you mean, him against them? Did he say?
The man was on tranquilizers and scotch. Every time he talked, he blew bubbles.
Tranquilizers?
Max gets in his limo every night after work, takes two tranquilizers the size of hand grenades, and washes it down with a ladle full of scotch. His driver helps him into his house, and he falls asleep on the floor of his den next to his dogs.
That's why there's no letters. The man's paranoid.
But I'm right. Remember when Max accused his next-door neighbor of shooting up the Cadillac on tires on his Cadillac?
Hey, guys, Max shoots his tires himself. We all know that.
Why would he do that?
He's got a shotgun, he's got a Cadillac, he's free on Sundays. Why not?
Does Max have any enemies?
Besides himself? I don't think so.
What do you mean?
No one hates Max the way Max hates Max.
I love it when you talk like Gertrude Stein.
They don't get it. We write comedy, Max does comedy. It's his rump out there in front of the cameras every week.
Is that his rump? No wonder he gets such big laughs.
Can you die? Max likes it in here with us. Hello there. Funniest man since Jacqueline, and he still throws up before every show.
$25,000 a week, I'd stick my fingers down my throat. Gee, I'll sure miss you all in Hollywood.
Oh, geez, he sold another script. What putt studio bought it this time?
MGM.
For how much?
$75,000.
No, I mean how much you want to bet you're full of crap.
Name
the price. $500 if you win. If you lose, we get to pull out all your transplants.
Have you guys heard the news? No? Of course not. No one else here cares about what's going on in this country. I'm the only one who takes interest in something besides jokes, cars, money, and baseball.
There you
go. I heard it in a taxi. Bill McCarthy called General George Marshall a communist.
Unbelievable.
He calls a five-star general of the army a card-carrying communist.
Even if he was a communist, why would he have cards printed up?
Hey, children! Wake up! It's time for school! You think this is a joke? America's on the brink of becoming a fascist state and this doesn't worry you?
McCarthy's in that case. A drunken fanatic. How long do you think he'll last?
Some of them lasted long enough to kill 6 million Jews.
I've met hotheads like McCarthy. He'll start a fight in an Irish bar one night and get a dart right between the eyes.
I feel so badly for General Marshall. Such a nice man, such a sweet face. Of all names to pick, why him?
I don't know. Val, did you ever see Marshall at any of the meetings?
Are you out of your mind? You don't make jokes like that. Some secretary outside hears that? Next thing you know, I'm being subpoenaed to Washington.
Val's right. No communist jokes. None of us are safe today. They got that blacklist thing, you know?
They got what?
Blacklist?
Three bags full.
They can put anybody on the blacklist they want.
That proof? In a second, they've got a waitlist to get on the blacklist.
Not if you tip the maitre d'.
I can't believe they think this is a joke. Did any of you see Edward R. Murrow last night?
I don't live in his neighborhood.
What do I have to do to impress you? This is serious.
Well, the whispering was good.
My God, this is a terrible time for all of us.
It's 20 after 10. She's right.
Oh my God, no.
What?
I have a cousin, my mother's nephew. He was a communist in college for 3 months and then he quit. What do I do if they ask me about him?
You take Fifth Amendment.
Or the Sixth Avenue subway. You'll get off in China.
Don't you see? You're playing right into McCarthy's hands. Fear through intimidation.
And he doesn't intimidate you? A United States senator who giggles like Porky the Pig.
My God, forgive me for mentioning this word. Nervous breakdown.
That's two words. God will never forgive you.
You know how Max hates McCarthy. Wait till he hears about this.
Wait till you hear about Max.
What?
He got a threatening letter.
From McCarthy?
No, he writes it himself.
He called me last night. Sitting in his den, hammered drunk, with a loaded shotgun in his lap.
Sanji was going to shoot the blokes.
He's got those two running dogs. Maybe that's all it is. He was just gonna go run.
Those dogs don't hunt. They point to food in supermarkets.
My God, forgive me for missing this again. Nervous breakdown.
Whoever wants to hear the bad news about Maggie, pick up the phone.
My God, someone pick up the phone?
I'll do it.
She's just a kid. What does she know about picking up a phone?
Hello? Oh, hi. Where are you? It's Ira. He's running late at his analyst.
I thought his analyst died.
He met a new one at the funeral. Just get here. We got problems.
Can I get this one?
I think I'm old enough now. Hello? Oh. Okay. Thanks, Helen. Max just walked in. He stopped off from the job.
Okay. Everyone calm down. Relax. What do we say to him?
Do we mention anything about the letters? Or the loaded shotgun?
He must know because Kenny told him last night.
We should figure out what we say to him. How long do you think he will pee in there?
I knew a guy with a German Shepherd who flew from Paris to New York. When they landed, he peed for 2 hours and 10 minutes.
Can you imagine what Lindenberg must have done?
You sure you still want to be head writer?
No.
Kittle, you're head writer now.
I quit. I'm trying to get pregnant. I got enough to worry about.
Ask your husband. Why should we do everything?
I quit!
Just tell me about you, Max. You were saying the response to Saturday's show was unbelievably good. Unbelievably good. And maybe the best ever.
I got 20 phone calls. I made 10 myself. That's how good it was.
Report on the show?
Yes, Max.
Unbelievably good. Maybe the best ever.
What did they say?
They said unbelievably good. Maybe the best ever.
Mug.
What?
Mug!
Make. He wants coffee in his mug. No cream for sugars.
Right, Max.
Did we get any more memos from NBC?
What?
Memos! Memos! They lost the damn memos!
No, Max. No memos.
No memos? They skipped the day without memos? They're saving them so they can memo me to death! Bury me in a folded memo in the Mount Memo Cemetery in Middle Park, New Jersey!
Here's your coffee, Max. Be careful, it's very hot.
Wahoo! What's
hot? You shouldn't drink hot things so fast, Max.
No, it's good. Boils the blood.
No one had asked for Max.
Took a bottle at home.
A bottle, that's how she cleared up.
Did you get any sleep last night, Max?
Oh yeah, slept like a bear.
Those bear sleeps are great, huh, Max?
You wake up in April, May, and feel like a million.
Okay, you worked today. What, did you a great show this week? No, not a great show, the best. Best show we ever did, you hear?
Sure, Max. It's always good to change it once in a while.
They started, we'll finish. You all heard it. NBC fired the first shot. Remember this day, everyone. A day that will live in infamy! March 6th, 1953.
It's March 8th, Max.
What are you, a historian? March 6th, March 8th, March 12th. Who gives a darn? The battle has started. The lines have been drawn. Now we have to plan our counterattack.
What's it
about? What's up, Max?
What's up? What's up? What's not down is up. What's up could be down, what's down could be up, you understand?
Certainly. Isn't it Newman's theory?
Husband.
Val called you to ask what theater she was in.
No, she already came home. She asked me this morning.
I didn't even know you were married.
Well, this is the first time we ever talked.
I can't remember anything. I think someone's drugging me, I swear to God!
Well, Max, that brings up another delicate subject.
You know, the other night, I fell asleep while I was staring at the ceiling. I thought I was dreaming about a ceiling.
First off, Max, you should know we all love you.
You know, sometimes I go into the kitchen, I take a hammer in the middle of the night, and I smash walnuts! Why do I do that?
I think Freud says it's a symptom of fear, Max.
But I'm not scared of walnuts. Do you want to hear the worst part? I thought we did, Max. When I eat, I can't even tell the difference between steak and fish anymore.
Why do they catch a steak, Max?
Help us with delicate subjects.
Hey, Max. NBC's calling for you.
And I knew right then that if I wanted to keep my job, I have to become as totally crazy as the rest of them.
Milk, no, I have your hat! I have your hat! Milk! Milk, no!
How's the call going with NBC, Max?
The call with NBC went fine.
Everything's okay?
I know.